Hey guys, what's up? Gonna just show you a quick video on testing out your blade. I know there's a lot of people that make blades at home, including myself and a lot of other guys out there. You need to start testing your blades. You definitely need to know what they're capable of. I do my own heat treat on my 1095 and my carbon steels. So, and I've been doing it for a long time. I mean, not 30 years like some of the masters out there, but long enough to know what my steel can handle and when I can't. So test out your blades, especially if you have them heat treated by somebody else. You know, find out what they can do before you ship them out, before you sell them for some good money out the door. So not a lot of people will show an abuse test like this on a knife that they're going to sell for, you know, $200, $250, but I think it's important. Definitely find a steel that you like using and stick with it. Don't bounce from steel to steel to steel to steel looking for the bigger, better everything. I mean, if that's your thing, you know, go ahead and do it, but definitely not what I'm about. I will do stainless steel when requested, but most of the time it's high carbon. This knife is just factory edge. It's not sharp enough to shave with by any means, but this test isn't about factory edge or sharpness. This test is about durability. So, just going to get started here. This is a 2x4. Again, this isn't even a 6-inch blade. Make sure that's on. Yep. So, ran out of steam a little bit there. Alright. Now I'm going to make you guys cringe. Are you ready? Alright. Make sure I get that on there. Look at that. Come on, guys. Can your knife do that? Would you try this with your knife? Straight as an arrow. No bends. Actually polished up the tip a little bit. Keep going. Alright. So, you ask yourself, your knife can do this? So, because you're doing something right. Alright guys, didn't mean the bitch there for a second, but just make sure you're doing it right. Later.